Luke 4:18.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised. If you add 19, it goes on to talk about the reason why Jesus was anointed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, this is Jesus speaking here. And Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I want us to pray this very evening for the anointing. Say anointing.
Anointing.
Hallelujah. Amen. I am not going to talk that much. I'm just going to scratch the surface. And how do you call it? Whip your appetite and whip your desire to go in for the anointing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. To desire the anointing, to be hungry for the anointing.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm telling you, if you understand what anointing is, you will follow anointing and forget money.
Yes.
For you didn't hear what I said.
Amen.
Listen and pay attention. I said, if you understand what is anointing, or what anointing is,
yes,
you will follow anointing and forget money.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you know what anointing can do, if you take time and you study in detail what anointing is capable of doing, you will realize that you don't need to even bother yourself. Get up and desire and go for it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. I don't want to talk too much, but to go into the exegesis or the root meaning of anointing and blah, 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 blah. But I just want you to know that when God decides to choose somebody and he empowers the person, hallelujah,
amen,
he empowers you and he protects you and he provides for you. If you have the Holy Spirit in the inside of you, anointing. Have I explained?
Yes.
When God chooses his servant who has the Holy Spirit in him or her, and he empowers, say empower.
Empower.
And he empowers you, automatically he protects you and he provides for you.
Amen.
You are anointed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God anoints for a purpose. Say purpose.
Purpose.
God does not just anoint, he anoints for a reason.
Amen.
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 There is a difference between the Holy Ghost being in the inside of you and you being anointed. Every child of God, every Christian has the Holy Spirit in him or her.
Amen.
Who don't have Holy Spirit in you? Lift up your right hand. If you don't have the Holy Spirit in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so the moment you confess the Lord as your personal Savior, at the moment you confess the Lordship of Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit comes to dwell in the inside of you.
Amen.
So every child of God has Holy Spirit in you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But it is a different thing to be anointed, and it's a different thing to have the Holy Spirit. But the Holy Spirit is the basis of being anointed, or to be anointed, or for God to anoint you. If you don't have the Holy Spirit, you cannot be anointed. But if you have the Holy Spirit, automatically being anointed will be easy and simple.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. So I have the Holy Spirit. And he has anointed me for a reason. So if God wants to use you to do his work, he anoints you.
Hallelujah.
So he does not just anoint, he anoints for a reason. And he anoints for a purpose. And Acts chapter 10, verse 38. Acts 10, 38. Are you there?
Yes.
He says what? How?
How?
God did what? So pause there. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with what?
The Holy Ghost.
And what?
With power.
So anytime you hear anointing, you have to hear power.
Yes.
Amen. Anytime you hear anointing, you have to hear what?
Power.
Any Christian, any child of God who is anointed, the devil fear you. By the way, we have levels of anointing.
Yes.
Say anointings, they are in levels.
Anointing, they are in levels.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But the moment God anoints you, he empowers you.
Amen.
So when you hear anointing, you hear power.
Hallelujah.
Any child of God who is anointed has power.
Amen.
And any child of God who is anointed, the devil fear you.
Yes.
How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were what? Oppressed with the devil, for God was with him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is this scripture, I think Luke 24:49 or so, where Jesus was telling them, wait in Jerusalem for the promise, and until the power of God comes upon you.
Amen.
Let's see if it is there. Luke 24:49 or so. Manuela, be smart. Am I right? He says, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But do what? Tarry ye here in the city of what? Oh, speak like you are here in the room. Of what?
Jerusalem.
Until ye be what?
Now.
With what?
Power.
From on high.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Every child of God is expected to be anointed because you have the Holy Ghost in you.
Hallelujah.
And God did not just give us the Holy Ghost for fun, but he gave it to us so that we will utilize it, use it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so if you are a child of God and you are not anointed, you are underutilizing the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
What example should I give? It's just like you are from the King's Palace. Hallelujah. The moment they give birth to you, in here, you are already rich.
Yes.
Am I telling lies? No. Even before they give birth to you, even in the stomach, you are rich.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is how anointing is. If you have the Holy Ghost, you are anointed. And if you have the Holy Ghost and you don't use it, you are underutilizing it. Now, can you think about it? To see the child of the king. What's her name? Amalia. If you see her with tattered clothes, standing by the roadside and begging, what will you say? Is it possible?
Never.
It's impossible.
Yeah.
It cannot happen. And that is what children of God we do. We underutilize what God has given to us. If you know what you have in the inside of you, I remember in the book of Acts, one time the apostles were using the anointing. They were using the power of God. And there is this man who thought that he can buy the anointing with money. So he went to them and told them that, please take money, give me some. Because he knows what that thing can do.
Yes.
He was using the evil one. And the evil one, what he was, giving to him.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. I want us to pray more. If I'm to go and go and go, I'll go and go and go and go. And by the time I realize, time is gone. But what I want you to know is that when you are anointed, one, devil fear you.
Hallelujah.
Two, you become very bold. You don't fear anything. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Three, you are able to break yokes of the enemy.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anointing brings money. Money.
Hallelujah.
Anointing. It changes destiny.
Hallelujah.
It blesses. Hallelujah.
Amen.
One time, when the prophet Elisha, he was home, and a widow came to him. Her husband was dead. They coming to take his children. When they came, but when the woman came, the prophet said, "What do you have at home?" And the woman said, "I have a pot of oil." And the prophet said, "Look, I have anointing." Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me show you what anointing can be.
Hallelujah.
Go and borrow vessels. Go into your room. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And begin to pour the oil. The anointing will bring continuous supply. Oh, you don't understand. I said the anointing will bring continuous what? Supply. And the woman poured and poured and poured and poured until there was no vessel anymore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It happened during the time of Elijah too. When he declared that there is not going to be rain. For 3.5 years, God fed him with birds. And then when the whole place got dried up, God asked him to go to a widow in Zarephath. When he got there, the widow said, "I don't have anything, just a little flour. I'm going to prepare so we eat and die, me and my son." He said, "I have something called anointing."
Hallelujah.
That anointing can change small flour and let it be plenty.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the woman said, "Okay." But he said, "You know what? To provoke the anointing, you bring me first. Let me eat." And she brought it to him. And according to the word of God, he didn't finish.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anointing can do whatever you can think about. Some people, your Christian life is not straight because you are not anointed. The devil is playing you like that is. You know that is? Put you on the leg like football. Put you like this. Tomorrow your head. Next time your waist. This time your this. Next day your day. Every day. Why? No anointing. Dry. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are anointed, you are like a hot saucepan that has been put on fire. Always hot. The devil cannot come close. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They cannot just touch you because you are hot. Be on your feet. I want you to desire and say, "God, anoint me." Sometimes men of God mystify anointing, and it looks like if you are not called a pastor, a prophet, an evangelist, a teacher of the word, you are not supposed to be anointed. No. Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 1 verse 8, he says, "And you shall receive what?
Power
afterward. The Holy Ghost has come upon you." Did he say you will receive power if you become a pastor? Hallelujah. But if you become, you allow the Holy Ghost to fill you, you receive power. And you need to build on it. How do we receive anointing? We receive anointing by praying to God, walking in righteousness, studying the word of God. Praying and saying, "God, fill me. I want you to anoint me." When Jesus was left the disciples and the Holy Ghost came upon them and they got anointed, there and then, around that time, Peter and John, they were going to the temple to do church, and there was a man seated by the gate. And he was asking of alms. But Peter said, hey, now my status is changed. I have something called anointing. That anointing has the ability to change things. And so I want you to get up from where you are. I'll give you something that goes beyond money.
Hallelujah.
And the man began to walk.
Amen.
By the shadow of Peter, when he's walking because of anointing, when the shadow falls on sick people, they receive healing.
Amen.
Close your eyes with me. Let the power of
the Holy Ghost
fall on you. Your voice and pray and speak to God. Pray more than ever before.
Amen.
And desire and tell God, God, anoint me, O God. I need you more. I want you to anoint me more. Increase me more. Lift your voice now. Lift your voice now. He will not be able to do it.
Thank you.
Open your eyes and look at it. Where the world is getting to, I think you need anointing more than whatever you can think about. You need God more than whatever you can think about. When was it? 3 days ago? Nothing happened. Nothing happened. He's very strong, energetic, very, very outgoing. When we're back in Ghana, he exercises more than everybody. And for today, he still exercises. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every morning he goes for his walk. Every evening he goes for walk. He's gone for walk, he's come back, came to take his bath, eating, sitting, watching television. Watching television, the wife said, I'm going to sleep. Said, okay, I'll join you soon. He wasn't coming, the wife came back to call. It's getting late, come and sleep. He was dead, in a chair. Didn't move, didn't go anywhere. Far be it from us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Just this morning, I hear the former vice president to come. And he went to gym, he was gymming, and he fell down and collapsed. They took him to hospital, he was dead. Somebody was telling, were you the one telling me that on Facebook this week, dead, 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 dead. You know what? Small time Jesus will come. Very, very small. The devil is working hard to get more people into hell. Seriously. This is the time you need to say, God, fill me more. I need you more. Fill me more. You need more of God and you need more of His anointing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That any time the devil will come around, there should be some fire burning around you.
Amen.
The devil is working hard. He knows that his time is too short, very limited. So he's doing overtime. If you also joke and you put worldly things in before you and you think about worldly things, worldly things, worldly things, you are missing the mark. Because he says, if you set your eyes on his kingdom and his righteousness, those worldly things, they will come by all means. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Close your eyes. You're going to pray again that, God, I need more of you. Fill me more with your anointing. I want to be heard. I want the devil to fear me. I want to speak for things to happen. I just don't want to be a normal Christian. I don't want to be somebody who only goes to church. I want to be a child of God that the enemy will fear. Close your eyes. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Begin to pray. Pray for the last time. Pray for the anointing. Pray for the power of God. Pray that He will touch you. Pray that He will protect you. Pray that He will be anointed. Pray that He will empower you. In the name of Jesus. I'm not going to be able to do that.